Is a vegan diet healthy? Absolutely. But not always. Is it possible to eat an unhealthy vegan diet? Yes. As a 3.7-year vegan, my health is great. And I do get enough B12 without a supplement, according to blood tests. It is true that B12 is not naturally found in plants, it comes from bacteria. It is possible to take supplements or consume foods fortified with B12 or other vitamins, minerals. A prime example are soy milks, some of which have B12 added in. My morning OJ also has some extra vitamin D in there. And on omega-3s, it comes from algae, not fish. They get it from the algae first, but it can also be found in flax seeds. However, when I first went vegan, I was doing a terrible job. I was almost underweight before I began the journey, and then I would lose 5 more pounds. Something was horribly wrong. My vegan diet at the time was very poor. I wasn't getting what my body needed. With any change in diet, it's important to make sure you'll be able to get what your body needs. In fact, most people don't get what they need on the standard American diet anyway, lest you have problems. And also, don't be a junk food vegan. Oreos and potato chips are vegan, but your body would not thrive on that. In summary, I feel my body thrives when I eat a smorgasbord of nutrients from a variety of sources. Look at your plate. Is it decked with a colorful selection of food? That is usually a good sign. I also like to eat large quantities of a single food, such as bananas, as a snack in the afternoon. Finally, I certainly get enough protein, also according to blood tests. Can't go wrong with some good old beans and rice. I feel great, my conscience is clean, and I think my food tastes even better than before I was vegan. I have greatly reduced my chances of suffering heart disease and a number of other diseases because of the change, and I make sure I get what my body needs to thrive, not just survive. I am a nutritional therapist and I can confirm that a vegan diet is probably the healthiest diet out there, if done right. You can be a vegan and eat like crap, and you can be an omnivore and eat like crap. You just need to eat healthy real food, regardless if you are a vegetarian or an omnivore. It is really easy to obtain all the nutrients needed from a vegan diet. Protein is a non-issue. The animals you eat, cows, chickens, lambs, actually get their protein from plants. Vitamins and minerals are way more abundant in plants, as well as fiber. Meat does not have any fiber at all. The only supplement you need as a vegan is B12, which you need to take a supplement for. Nowadays, because of factory farming, all animals are injected with B12, as they do not have access to soil, and if they do, it is extremely depleted of microorganisms, i.e. B12, so either you get it through an animal or directly from a supplement. Dairy, meat and eggs have actually been linked to the three main causes of deaths in the US, unlike vegetables. We are so brainwashed that we even feel compelled to wonder whether a diet comprised of vegetables, fruits, grains, beans, nuts, seeds, etc. is healthy. Of course it is healthy. The main medical organizations have admitted that veganism is indeed a healthy diet and it is recommended for people of all ages, children and pregnant women. Yeah, you have to make sure you get all your nutrients, but you also have to do that on an omni diet. Bonus, it is funny how many people become experts in nutrition as soon as you ask about veganism. Anyone who has done minimal research knows that veganism is a very healthy diet. If you eat whole foods, regardless if you chose to eat meat or not, it is a fact. First off, veganism is not even remotely bad for a person, but the word means different things to different people, especially health-wise. Being a vegan can just mean someone who ethically doesn't use or consume animal products, but still eats a junky, non-meat version of the standard American crappy diet. That may still be good for the spared tortured animals, but crappy for the human animal eating it with no regard for their own well-being, kind of a weird dichotomy to me. I don't eat animals but don't really identify as a vegan, because I see the lack of animals in my diet as a smart and compassionate choice I will share about if asked, but not as a militant agenda to pontificate about or hold over others' heads, alienating instead of educating. I think of veganism as a very nutritious, whole plant food diet devoid of animal products and processed foods, including oil, which is just a more caloric junk food than sugar with no nutrition at all, read any label. It is truly a diet that is healthy for everybody. In fact, it is proven to be the healthiest diet considering that vegan Seventh-day Adventists are the healthiest and longest living population on the planet. Blue Zones the Okinawans used to be too, with a diet that was mostly sweet potatoes and veggies, less than 1% animal products, but all that changed fast when the fast food meatheads like McD's, KFC and all the others invaded the island and ruined it. People hate to hear that eating meat is not a good thing health-wise, and will spout all the outdated erroneous beliefs in defense. We need protein, there is more than enough in all plant foods. If you consume enough calories you will get enough protein. You need to know how to combine foods to get the right ratio of amino acids for a complete protein. Wrong, your body will get what it needs automatically. Frances Morlap, who popularized the idea long ago, admitted she was mistaken, but the BS lingers with meat eaters. We need meat, milk, etc. to be healthy. Wrong again. They are foreign proteins with multitudes of health risks and totally unnecessary, and so on. You know what they say about opinions, and everyone has one. But I rely on evidence-based fact, especially when it saved my life. The only legit issue is B12, which is a concern for vegans and non-vegans. It is not made by animals, but by soil bacteria, and is just stored by animals. When we stopped drinking from streams, wells and other untreated open sources, and began filtering and adding chlorine to our water supply, improving hygiene, we cut down drastically on disease, but also eliminated B12 from our diets. Eating animals can confer some recycled B12, but even meat eaters should take a B12 supplement because it isn't a reliable source anymore with the chemicals we dump into the soil and animals. Veganism, a whole food, plant-based diet, is a wonderful choice for you, for the animals and for the world. Raising food animals uses huge amounts of fresh water, destroys forests, land, and native animal populations, contributes more to climate change than cars and factories, and on and on. See Cowspiracy and What the Health for some entertaining insight. All the best. Yes. What are the benefits of being a vegetarian? Until a few years ago, the benefits of vegetarianism were more anecdotal than clinically proven. However, over the last couple of decades, several studies have indicated that a person who adopts a vegetarian diet will have a lower body weight. One study carried out by Cancer Research UK found that those who continue eating meat will carry on putting on more weight over a 5-year period, compared to those who switched over to vegetarianism. The study found that vegans put on even less weight as they get older, compared to vegetarians and meat eaters. The study looked at 22,000 meat eaters, fish eaters, vegetarians, and vegans. Three have better cholesterol levels, scientists at the University of Toronto and St. Michael's Hospital demonstrated that a vegetarian diet made up of specific plant foods can lower cholesterol as effectively as a drug treatment. The study, published in the July 23 issue of the Journal of the American Medical Association, compared a diet of known cholesterol-lowering, vegetarian foods to a standard cholesterol-reducing drug called lovastatin. For the diet reduced levels of LDL, the bad cholesterol known to cause clogging in coronary arteries, in participants by almost 29%, compared to a 39% decrease in the lovastatin participants. The diet consisted of a combination of nuts, almonds, soy proteins, viscous fiber, high fiber, foods such as oats and barley, and a special margarine with plant sterols, found in leafy green vegetables and vegetable oils. Live longer. Several studies have shown that vegetarians have a much lower risk of becoming obese, developing diabetes, cancer, and cardiovascular diseases. All these conditions and diseases reduce one's life expectancy. See the list of related articles below. Have a lower risk of developing cancer. Several studies have shown a reduced risk of developing many different types of cancer among vegetarians, compared to meat eaters. A recent study carried out by UK researchers, working on the European Prospective Investigation into Cancer and Nutrition Oxford, EPIC Oxford, found that vegetarians had a significantly lower overall risk of developing cancer, compared to meat eaters. 5. The study also found, however, that vegetarians have a higher risk of developing cancer of the colon. Have a lower risk of developing several diseases. See the list of related articles below. In them are mentioned several diseases and conditions that a meat eater is more likely to develop, compared to a vegetarian.